أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him, and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. For Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is his Sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. And to you, as well as every Muslim, that we say congratulations for the month of Ramadan. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a means of forgiveness and to make it a blessed month for every Muslim everywhere. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should be grateful and thankful that Allah had extended our life until today so that we can be witness to the coming of the new month. And it should be a happiness, joys to every Muslim, male and female, because he have a new opportunity to get more closer to Allah, to enslave yourself more to Allah, to be one of the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them during this month. My brothers and sisters, the month of Taqwa had came to you. The month of the Quran had came to you. The month of fasting had came to you. The month of forgiveness had came to you. The month of the Quran had came to you. We can count more and more. We see the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the month that will bring to our memory the great victory of the Muslims, the early Muslims, and for them to take over their property and sanctify and to purify the house of Allah from the shirk and the mushrikeen. The opening of Mecca, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ, was in Ramadan. Ramadan is not a month for you to be lazy. If you read in the history of Islam and Muslims, you found most of the greatest achievement of the Muslims have been in Ramadan. So I say to you, as well as myself, congratulations. You have a ni'mah, you have a blessing, you had a favor that Allah had bestowed in you. Allah had made you exist in this life, and you are living and alive today. So to welcome this month of Ramadan. My dear respected brothers and sisters, it is very important that we be grateful, thankful to the ni'mah of Allah. You have to understand, some Muslims who used to be in your locality, or maybe in your mosque, or in your family, they were there in Ramadan last year, they are not here this year. What's the difference between them and you? That you have more chance and more opportunity to get more closer to Allah. I will tell you today, before we even start Ramadan, which tomorrow, inshallah, we're going to be fasting. Today is the completion of the Sha'ban. This is the departure of the month of Sha'ban. And tomorrow, we'll be observing the fasting. I tell you, it's going to be in and out before even you feel it. This is it. You are here today. Maybe your grandfather, maybe your sister, maybe your cousin, somebody else is gone. They are in the grave. But you are here. That means Allah giving you a chance that you can multiply your blessings, that you can get more closer to Allah. So if you waste your time, if you play games with wasting, delaying, so-called tasweef, inshallah, it will be Ramadan, we're going to depart from you before even you feel it. And the next thing they're going to say, is it Eid or is it going to be one day more for Ramadan? You better hurry up and wake up if you are not awake already. You need to understand that Ramadan is in, that now you have to be a different person, that you have to appreciate the ni'mah of Allah. And you have to show your gratitude to Allah that He had extended your life until this Ramadan had came to you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in hadith, which he reported by Utbah, may Allah be pleased with him, he told us about some of the virtues of this month. One of them, تُفْتَحُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَتُغْلَقُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ وَتُغَلُّ فِيهِ الشَّيَاطِينِ وَيُنَادِي مُنَادِي كُلَّ لَيْلَةِ يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ هَلُمْ وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِ أَقْصِرْ. My dear respected brothers and sisters, pay attention to these words. The Prophet ﷺ letting you know about Ramadan. So Ramadan comes with the blessings already. So now you need to double this effort because Ramadan comes already with its tools. So you have to be prepared also yourself, because Allah already given you something that you can start with. And the Prophet ﷺ say that the gates of Jannah will be open. So Jannah is waiting in you. Jannah is waiting for you. Walk in, move, do something to get you closer. تُفْتَحُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. As for hellfire, the gates and the doors of hellfire will be shut. So that means you need to slow down from your evil, from your haram, from all things displeasing to Allah, or displeasing to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have other help from Allah. تُغَلُّ فِيهِ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَفِي حَدِيثِ مَرَضَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. That the shayateen will be chained. So now, it's you and yourself. Don't blame it too much on the shaitan, because one of your enemies is going to be Lot. Is going to be Lot. So now you have more energy towards the good, and you have more opportunity to obey Allah more. Now if it's going to be any problem, it's you and yourself that you are not willing to submit. You don't want to come to be in the rank. So the shayateen, or the worst of the shayateen, going to be chained. Every night a caller. Every night. tonight, a caller would say, oh, seeker of God, hurry up, come on. Seeker of God, come on.